eSportBets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. eSportBets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
Oh, what are you guys still doing here? Oh, that's right, there's another game coming up between Fnatic and Hellraisers, and it is going to be one sick game on Mirage. So welcome to the show, everyone. I hope you are ready for it. And of course, Semler and Vendetta. I mean, that last game, do you think we can outdo that this time? That was a sick comeback.
It's going to be hard, but we have to keep in mind that both of these teams are coming off a victory versus Titan.
So, this is to establish dominance.
Exactly. And this leaves, you know, obviously the hope for a really good game. And I'm excited to see how Fnatic plays Virage as well, because we've seen Hellraisers play it quite a bit as of late.
Yeah, so, both of them have slain French teams in recent times as well. Hellraisers won more than Fnatic. They've both won their last five games. I mean, this is definitely a big clash here. So one of these teams is going to lose. Hellraisers are sitting at the top of the group right now as well for Star Series with an 8-0-1 record. Fnatic kind of in the mid of the pack, although they're only at 3-0, so they haven't played as many games yet.
All right then. So, I mean, it's the end of the line for one of these two teams. That's what you're saying. You know, the win streak is going to be broken tonight.
Unless they tie.
Yeah, I was going to say, unless they tie, maybe. That's not quite
because
a loss.
You can't actually do that in SLTV.
Don't jinx it.
Well, you don't want to see a tie.
One team is going to lose here.
That's a bold prediction.
There's no gray area. Well, the thing is, what's crazy? What, Anders? Did you predict Titan to win 16-14?
Yes, I did, and it was.
It was close. It was close. Fnatic, you know, the thing is that my prediction was out the window as soon as the first half was over with Titan getting 10 rounds. Like, there was no way they weren't going to pick up at least one round on the T side.
Yeah.
But I was just like, that would be the most sick thing to happen, like if Titan managed to rally when it's 14-14 and they get the final two rounds.
Yeah, look, it could have gone either way, obviously, at that stage. You know, it's just down to details, but Fnatic had some incredible rounds the last two rounds, very enjoyable to watch. And I don't know, I mean, I still want to say, as I pointed out earlier, I think this is a pretty cool sign of Titan actually just improving a lot. I mean, if you match up the Titan that we just saw play with the Titan that we saw play before DreamHack Summer, there's a really big difference, and I think that is the most notable thing. I mean, there's lots of stuff they can do to improve right now still. That's always the case, and I think if they go back and watch the replay, they're going to see a lot of that stuff, so no doubt. But, I mean, still, this is I think that's a good sign right now for the French team, no doubt.
I think we saw both versions of Titan coming out. You had the new fresh Titan up till 14-7, and after that it was just same old.
That's the thing. I really feel like Titan right now, like, their biggest thing is just momentum, right? Closing games on. It's almost as if we're looking at like Fnatic from Copenhagen Games, right? Where they'll get ahead and then they just can't finish a game. They can't win the game. And the other team gets back into it. We saw that twice now from Titan tonight, versus Hellraisers and versus Fnatic. Both Titan had firm, they had ways to finish the game. They could have just taken it and ended it, and then they just time and time again let the team get back into the game and then win. So I don't know, Titan. I feel like the thing they have to focus on right now is just finishing a game. How do you just end it?
Well, we do have 8 players on the server, so we are getting closer to having this game underway. But in the meantime, let me remind all of you that tomorrow is a very big day for us here on the channel. Of course, we just sort of started this channel, and we love you guys to tune in and help us out with the tournament tomorrow. We're going to have 4 great teams. It's LDLC, Na'Vi, Titan, and Fnatic, and they're going to be playing in 3 best-of-3 games tomorrow. So it's going to be all day, basically. It's starting at 6 o'clock, and we'll keep going, well, until we're done with. So I hope you guys are going to come in and support us with that. We really need your help with it. And while you're here, you can obviously also go and check out our sponsor's Facebook page. And like that, you can participate in the raffle. That's facebook.com/ Case King Gaming. You can also, if you type exclamation mark follow in the chat, you'll be given the links, not just to that, but also to our Twitter pages and also to our newly created YouTube account, which has all the VODs of everything we're going to cast on this channel. So a big thanks to the people who are helping us with editing the videos. But that should be up usually no more than, 12 hours later. That's what we're aiming for. And sometimes, hopefully, even just a couple of hours after the cast, we'll be ready with those on YouTube. So if that's a big change, YouTube VODs a little bit more reliable than Twitch VODs. So, what do you guys think? Fnatic or Hellraisers, if you have to pick a team, and you do, because I'm forcing you, which one is it?
I'm going to go with Hellraisers this game, because they're the ones I've seen the most of on Mirage in current lineups. So, yeah. And they've looked good on Mirage as well, so I expect big things.
Yeah.
They really did look like they had it panned out. What I'm really interested to see is the op duel between Kucher and J-Dub. Or Markolov, actually, because Markolov has been picking up the AWP on Mirage as well, so...
He has.
Yeah, I think actually we might see Olafmeister as well pick up an op on this map. Or I wouldn't be surprised to see it, at least.
You know what? That's a good point. Olafmeister... Like, both of these teams actually have a pretty strong options for double op play.
Yeah.
They do.
They really do. Olafmeister and JW are just... Olafmeister's a monster with the AW. With the AWP.
Well, we certainly have a lot to look for here in this game. I hope you are ready for it. My dorks are certainly ready. They're getting excited here. It's going to be a best of one. SLTV Star Series Season 10, Fnatic versus Hellraisers. And welcome to Room on Fire. I'm Anders with me, Semler and Vendetta, of course. And we're going to have a knife round to decide who's going to be starting on what side. So hope you guys enjoy the show. Remember to follow the channel and then just sit back and enjoy some great Counter-Strike.
Let's see how this breaks down. Ben, how do you think, how important is it is, do you think, to start on the CT side here? Because this is a CT-sided map, after all.
I don't think it's the end-all be-all, but I think it's definitely an advantage, just getting into that feel-good stage, I guess, or that feel-good mood for your team, just getting off to an easy start, or a potentially easier start.
Will be Fnatic to pick up those rounds, and I've in the meantime closed the window so that the dogs next door don't actually rile up my dogs. That's what's happened. So, but on the problem when I close the window is that it actually turns this room into a sauna. So that's what it is.
Well, sacrifices, Anders. Sacrifices. Sacrifices. Although pug barks are pretty cute, like the dogs themselves, in a weird sort of way.
Yeah, but if anybody's going to wake up this whole house, I want it to be me screaming at the game and not, not the pugs.
Why isn't Flusha giving the dualies to Olafmeister?
I don't know, but look at this. Look at this coming out here. Fnatic, they did this on Inferno as well. They stacked four people in Inferno and one bomb site. Now they're doing it on Mirage. This is just the new Fnatic thing, and Crims is about to maybe throw away this whole round, walking up very aggressively, and oh, great headshot, but the second one won't land, and now the B bomb site is lost, and this is going to be an incredibly tough retake, especially with Flusha falling asleep over at the A bomb site.
Right, why is Flusha waiting? They saw the bomb, didn't they? I mean, Crims would have spotted the bomb carrier right there. The bomb is about to get planted on this B site as well. There we go, it's done. Angel trying to put some shots through to Kitchen, but there's the man advantage now for this retake on A.
Look at JW.
Oh, you're right. Coming up from behind. Definitely some sneaky play coming in. He's going to be rushing right through. Markolov picks on one. JW takes a whole day to get a single kill. He hasn't actually picked it up yet. Oh, and he goes down. So now it's down to Flusha the Cowboy with the dual elites just running in. He has plenty of bullets, but not enough HP to survive a shot to the face. And, I mean, I don't know what happened to JW that round. That was very sad.
He probably should have picked up that kill. Or actually, there's no doubt that he should have picked up at least a kill.
Do you know why he missed it, though? Because when you're supposed to pick up the kill, when there's no doubt you're supposed to pick up the kill, that's the one time that you miss a shot.
That's true, it's true. But Hellraisers did the exact same thing that we've seen them do the previous three games on Mirage. It's the same B push Kucher with a Deagle in mid, and the rest of them just posted up in B apps. And it's working out for them. It doesn't seem like any team is interested in anti-stratting them at all.
No, definitely not. Though Pronax with a good pickup of an apartment, and but other than that, this round is working out pretty well for Hellraisers, and even Angel is going to come in here and make sure that Pronax won't be surviving with this Galil that he stole for that much longer, and he's being boxed in on the other side by Kucher, so I think Hellraisers have a pretty good grip of this. Oh, this is a great position from Pronax. I like this. He's going to pick up a second kill.
And he does it. Yeah, I was surprised, actually. I wasn't expecting him to actually pick up that kill, seeing as how he was so low. JW catches Kucher off guard, waiting patiently on balcony. He gets rewarded. And now it's Doja and Markolov, one coming in through connector and the other Markolov with the bomb sitting on short. They're trying to make up their mind as to where they want to go here, Hellraisers.
Yeah, oh, and JW is going to get picked off here. Doja, what are you doing? You just heard him. There it is. Going to pick off one guy in window, and now Markolov is coming in. That was looked like Doja just couldn't hear a thing. But Pronax has been patiently waiting for a very long time in these A apartments, and that might actually throw Hellraisers off guard. They might think by now he surely must have rotated out. And if they try and put the bomb down here, that could end badly.
Look at Doja, though. Doja is already seeing this coming. He's got Pronax, and now it's going to come down to Flusha. He's got the 5-7 Flusha with the perfect nade onto Markolov, though. This is into a 1v1 now. Pre-fire onto Doja. Clips him. It comes close, but it's a quad kill for Doja in the end.
I don't know if... Maybe it's because we've been had all this soccer on TV with the World Cup and everything, but it looked like he was actually trying to headbutt that grenade. And like maybe he's just been watching so much that he thought, I got it. Definitely just going to get it down. All right. Well... That was a very close round from Fnatic. I mean, a great eco round from them, and thanks to Pronax mostly. That was some nice work up in the apartments.
It definitely was. Still, though, I think they need one more round for it to really matter in the long run. If they can do the same or something close to this upcoming round, then that's actually going to hurt Hellraisers quite a bit, economically speaking. So I wouldn't be surprised if we see Hellraisers play somewhat or even slower.
Hey, look at Markolov, though. Markolov's only got a CZ-75 and Kevlar helmet. It's probably going to be Markolov with the AWP in the round to come. That's what makes me think here, that he's going to be aiming for it. Kucher has spotted the man waiting in the corner on short, though. Good nade by Flusha. Lands right on top of him. He's got the 250. He gets Kucher, and Markolov is so very low as well. But Adrian with the wraparound will get rid of Flusha on the B side and even get a second one on Olafmeister. It's JW now caught in mid. 1v4 retake. Not likely.
He has a flip knife as well.
He does. I'm a
little bit jealous. A little bit jealous, yeah.
A little bit. This is... How did he get it so quick? Did he just get insanely lucky and open a case?
Yeah, maybe he just straight up boarded. Adrian does pick up a quad kill, but I'm sure one of these tournaments coming up, he's going to leave his PC on, you know, just leave it and, you know, I can always go and transfer it
to
my account.
Yeah, it'll be fine. It's all good. We got this.
Coming for your knife, JW. You've been warned. 3-0, and moving into the fourth round, still AKs all around, so Markolov actually not picking up an AWP yet, which I thought he was definitely going to do as well. But Fnatic, look at this wonderful push. Crimson, JW, I love these underpass pushes like that, and Doja might be caught off here. Two people waiting, and Doja had no idea.
It's a bit of a shame, but then Adrian, what a shot from Adrian.
And Markolov too.
Taken out as well, but that was a stellar shot from Adrian. It's not often you see it so clean like that.
I mean, Markolov got a shot jumping just as he landed. He just... I don't know, fired the AK and got the round off. Very nice job from Hellraiser so far, actually bringing it back here. Kucher with another one, and JW goes down. This is not looking good for Fnatic. It's a 1-on-3, and Flush is just trying to see if he can clutch this, which he's very good at, but, I mean, Hellraiser should have this round.
They definitely should. Flush, he's got a flash out onto the site now. And that was just very well done there by Hellraisers as well. They both peek at the same time. So Flusha kills one, sets it up for the other one, for the other Hellraisers member to clean it up.
Yeah, I think it's pretty evident. I mean, the initial plan for Fnatic was very well executed with the aggressive push into underpass, but it also left them extremely susceptible to an A push, and Hellraisers might have gotten a tiny bit lucky there with what site they opted to go for, but it definitely worked out. But I don't think we're going to see it being that effective the next time around.
Look, is there some kind of bet going on?
What?
Okay, apart from Pronax getting killed there, did Markolov make a bet with Fnatic that he wouldn't actually buy a rifle? Because he's got $6,300 and he's got a CZ-75.
I don't know, maybe he's not going to buy it as long as it's not necessary. He realized they were going to be ecoing, so he just thought, I might as well just play the bank here and get some money.
He's about to get another kill here. JW reacts in time and gets the headshot on Markolov. Markolov, you're getting punished. There we go.
Crim's left. Bomb is down as well, so it is going to be pretty quick 5-0 in favor of Hellraisers. And this is a problem for Fnatic. It's not one that they can't, you know, they can come back from this. I mean, considering the comeback they did on Inferno, we don't want to rule them out. But the problem is they're on the less favored side here. They should be winning, you know, 3-2 right now, or anything other than 5-0, basically.
Nice play there by Crims, though. Picks up one kill before getting taken out in turn. So two kills on an eco. Actually, not too bad by Fnatic. They do manage to do a little bit of damage here. Now we get to see Markolov. There it is. There it is. Okay. And JW's got the AWP for Fnatic, so we have to be looking towards mid here. We have to be looking towards mid. Is that where this fight's going to happen?
And Markolov is running there, and JW's actually not even going to be going. He's up in the apartments trying to get a kick pick off on somebody, and he might get a chance here. Kucha's going to be grenading on in, maybe once. No, he's just going to go for the straight peek, and JW misses the shot, and that is going to cost him his life. And a big problem here for Pronax and Olofmeister inside the side. Olofmeister also taking 40 damage from a different grenade, and it's looking pretty good for Hellraisers early on.
That was perfect play from Hellraisers. It almost makes me think like they knew that JW would be there. Pronax walking up on balcony will find Kucher, and then Olofmeister catches Angel trying to push through smoke. Big play here by Fnatic actually turning this around. Hellraisers kind of giving them the opportunity in the end.
Yeah, a little bit confusion coming out there from Hellraisers. Seemed like they wanted to coordinate that push so that they pushed together, but they actually pushed one at a time. And now Flusher coming in to clean up the middle. A great adjustment for Fnatic. Nicely done from the Swedish team. You know, losing your AWP like that early on definitely could be just, you know, wrecking the team and just being a lot of confusion going on. But they stabilized.
They did actually manage to stabilize this. Adrian now the last man alive. He's got quite a bit of gear on him, but not a real hope to get onto a site 1v4 like this. They're just going to lock everything down, Fnatic, and play the time. They don't have to go hunting for him. They really don't. The only man who's kind of just poking about is Olofmeister, and that's pretty much what Olofmeister does since like the days of LGB, pushing into T-spawn. That's his thing.
It's true, and he has a pretty high success rate doing it as well. Somehow he just has, you know, the timing down pretty much just right. Adrian takes down Flusher, and the key for Fnatic here is just coming out of this round with as many people alive, and they do take down three players. So what do you think, Vendetta? I mean, that was a pretty good scenario over at the A-bomb side from Pronax and Olofmeister.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think it's fortunate that they, as you said, normally losing an AWP could be potentially devastating for a team. But I think it was okay because he wasn't holding down the middle. So they never lost control over mid. And that does a lot for your team. You don't really get rocked by losing a guy in apps, especially with a Wolfmeister and Pronix already on A site.
Well, JW is going to have the chance to redeem himself right here. AWP in hand. He misses the first shot, and now they're going to be rushing forward. Flush is there to help out, and Fnatic seem to have a pretty good control here, except for that one grenade that actually could have done some damage to Flusher. But they keep soldiering on, and Flusher gets another grenade kill, and there's the shot from JW, leaving Adrian once again alone in a 1-on-3. So nice. I mean, it's good to see the Swedish team bringing it back, and they kind of need to do it right here.
Really exciting play as well. I mean, it's just a full-on firefight for like 30 seconds. They just don't stop. This is just mid control. It's so clear right now what both of these teams are trying to do. It's basically just put up as strong a fight as possible for mid and make sure that nobody really has it in the end. And Fnatic, two rounds running, have managed to come out ahead.
Yeah, I actually wouldn't be too surprised if we saw Hellraisers going back towards that A push that we've seen so much of as of late, with Adrian more or less just walking out of apps uncontested. Like, yet to see how he managed to do that all the time, but I wouldn't be surprised if we saw Hellraisers shift focus towards A more heavily.
One thing to say is that Adrian is top fragging right now by a pretty good margin, 13-1-4. Like, he is definitely putting in work. The runner-up on his team doesn't even have half the frags that he does. So if they want to rely on Adrian with the A plays, go for it, Hellraisers.
Oh, they will deny it. I was going to say, if they let him put the bomb down here, that would be a big misplay. But they do manage to take him down earlier on. And even if with all of Adrian's kills, they actually don't have that much money, but they're still going to buy. I think they realize as well that Fnatic have won rounds, straw two in a row, but they've lost a couple of players in both those rounds. So I think this is a pretty smart choice from Hellraisers.
Yeah, they're trying to break the bank. Simple as that.
Oh, JW, are you joking me? On top of the smoke, actually a big risk. But that has to be one of the sexiest movements we've seen in a very long time. Huge credit to JW for showing us that little detail. Now, if you could have just got a kill, it would have been 10 out of 10, no doubt about that. Angel will take down Olofmeister, though, and JW still waiting for a kill, and there it is. It's going to pick one up and then run away. Now it's Flush's turn. Going to wrap around Angel, and actually, he goes down.
Catches him off guard there. Angel now looking to catch JW over in window, but JW is long gone. At this point, we have to look to Adrian because he's already snuck his way out onto the B site. There's a man waiting. He has no idea. Crimson gets completely caught off guard.
And JW gets a leg shot in. And actually, JW did see Adrian walking out the corner of his eyes. Obviously, he had his focus somewhere else, but that was incredibly unfortunate. And even a chance for a knife then. Now, Pronax, obviously, without much of a chance to do anything other than just hold on to this gun. And that's a problem for Fnatic. Their economy is not yet quite good enough.
Not at all. Not at all. It's actually crucial that Pronax holds onto this gun. But even if he does, it's going to be a very close thing for them to be buying here. They have one member, Olafmeister, with $50. Two of them are not even at 2K. So, I mean, if Pronax holds onto the gun, Ben, I don't know. In this kind of situation, would you see yourself going for a force buy?
Probably not. I think it's too little across the team, really, to force up. It doesn't really make sense, because if they lose this force buy, which is, would have been a really weak one, then they would have just dug themselves into a bigger and bigger pit. So I think it's better what they're doing now and having JW buy a mag 7 and kind of even things out.
Yeah, but I actually think if they had saved that one rifle on Pronax, I think they pretty would have forced it up. But this time already, great grenade. JW, he tried to be sneaky down in the underpass, thought he had them caught out, but Doshi has already died once to that kind of push, so this time he just pre-nades it, and it's going to be just fine. That's actually, wow, 47 damage at that range on Kucha with the Mach 7. It's terrifying.
That's a lot of damage. That's JW, though, for you. Somehow he makes it work. I mean, now he really is kind of caught, though. I mean, he's boxed in. Doja's waiting for him at the top of the stairs, and he's actually about to run right into Doja here. Doja gets caught by Krims, actually, so a big play here by Fnatic.
Yeah, working out quite well. Pronax, Angel has to stay alive here. This is pretty important. It's a 4-on-4, and it's definitely favoring Hellraisers, but they don't want to lose another player, and they will be able to take down Pronax, so that's pretty good. That opens up the A-bomb side a lot. The rest of Fnatic realizes they are rotating in, and Krims does have an AK. There's still some chances here.
Look at Flusha, though. He's got 7 HP, but he's got a 5-7. This is lethal range. If they try and get onto the site, a headshot will do it. Does he spot one out? Yes, he does. He gets one kill, but that's all. Adrian, right around the corner, will pick him off.
Yeah, and unfortunately, Krims goes down. So, JW, Mag 7, and entry frag or two here. Maybe just actually picking up the AK and running, I think, would definitely be the smarter choice. So, yep, he's just going to book it. That's it.
Book it. That's it. He's done.
Run to the helicopter.
But that's actually just the best play, because Olafmeister, again, doesn't have hardly has any money at all. I mean, he went into this round, I think, with 1450. He didn't spend a dime, and then he got instantly picked off in the apartment. So being able to hand over an AK to Olafmeister or drop another rifle for him, that's great for Fnatic going into this next round.
Yeah, it is actually kind of crucial, I think. Otherwise, Olaf would have... I mean, yeah, I guess he could buy from us, but AK is definitely a lot better. So we'll see if the Swedish team can get back on their feet. It looked like they were about to stand up. I mean, they have these two consecutive rounds in the middle of the first half here, but they need a lot more. I mean, Hellraisers, I think, would have been fine having 6 rounds on this first half. 7 rounds, that's dangerous territory right now for Fnatic.
I think they need 8 rounds, really, going into the T half. Obviously, we haven't seen them play much on the T half of Mirage, but Hellraisers have been looking so strong on their CT sides, really, on this map. So I think Fnatic does need that 1 round cushion that they could get.
This is just really impressed with how well Hellraisers are playing all across the board tonight. They just look indomitable right now.
And look at the
timing.
And
this is really scary.
Timing of this boost with Kucha is so good, because they're both looking down the middle. Kucha's going to be walking out right behind them. Even Pronax picking up that kill won't matter. He's going to get the one from behind. JW. Oh, he actually jumps forward. So very nicely done from JW. Now Kucha still has to try and find this kill. Otherwise, that backstab isn't going to be nearly as effective. And Flusher is there. Great timing from Fnatic. That could have been much worse for them. Now, the bomb might still go down if Markolov can get here in time, but Fnatic have done well so far.
Oh, Krims, the timing that Doja has, but Flusher is there to make up for it. A freebie there for Hellraisers. Krims getting caught with the nade in hand, but now if they spotted out Markolov, they know exactly where he is. Markolov has 40 seconds to get onto this site and get a plant down.
Looking for it. Still got 56 HP, which is actually not that much against this AK and M4, and he is going to go down. So JW with a good double. And Fnatic, I thought they were going to lose that round. As soon as I saw that boost from Kucha, I thought that's going to be the end of the round. But they managed to survive it.
Yeah, JW doing a bit of an aggressive move that might have cost him normally, but it worked out perfectly because he jumped just out of range from Kucher. So Kucher ends up getting one frag, and once JW picks up that second frag, there's no real more oomph, I guess, to that A fake.
Yeah, that kind of seals it, doesn't it? It ends right there. What are they going to do, Hellraisers? They've got the bomb drop all the way back towards T-spawn, so this is a game that's just about picking people off right now. That's what they want to do, and are they going to try for the boost again? I mean, it almost worked last time. But they are going to switch it up a little bit and just smoke off towards the middle and then see if they can peek in. But the bomb that far over, I'm really wondering. Oh, look at Adrian looking for the smoke. Did he catch Crims? Not yet.
Not quite sure if he did. But just to put the emphasis on how important this round is, it's one of those one for two rounds, right? Because neither team has much money going into it, and Kucher catching flush off guard is not the way to start. But Crims, with a great position, manages to find Adrian. And this is going to open things up. But now the A site, Angel steps forward and can't quite get Pronax, but Doja will.
Hellraisers seem to be attacking just the whole map right now. I mean, everywhere is where they're at. So that makes it really hard for Fnatic to know what's happening. But they are still finding great positions. I mean, look at Crims in the back here. Who's just going to be walking in, and he still gets the headshot. Think Crims should have probably come out on top then. And I mean, look at Kucher. He's got 2 HP. That could have been Fnatic. All of Meister has to clutch it.
Well, yeah, exactly. It's a 1v2, but Kucher is so very low. 2 HP. This is possible for All of Meister. And they've stacked it up, Hellraisers, as well. They're going for a bit of the cheek here. They're expecting Olafmeister not to think that they'll both be in the same position. Olafmeister just trying to check all the parts on this side as thoroughly as possible. But Markolov is just standing out in the open. No fear. Stands Olafmeister down.
And now no money left on Fnatic. But I think you're absolutely right, and that's a crucial detail as well. It may seem like it's really dumb to have two people in the exact same spot, but I think you're right. If Olafmeister had killed one of them, he would have instantly been thinking there might be someone behind the truck, there might be someone up in the apartments. He's not going to be thinking there's going to be another one down towards the catwalk. That's just not logical.
It's one of those gambles, right? If it pays off for Hellraisers, it's stellar. If not, but that was just very clean play from Hellraisers. Markolov just standing his ground like that as well. No fear at all. Olafmeister will find a kill at range with that USPS, and JW has found one. So this is actually on an eco run for Fnatic. They've just crushed the push mid from Hellraisers.
And Kucher killed a teammate trying to get to the kill that was over on catwalk. So a little bit of confusion from the terrorist side here. And that's exactly what Fnatic need. They just need some sort of momentum. If they can make this 8-7, then they're still in the game. But it's going to be an uphill battle. JW with a good kill. And I mean, yeah, a bit of a screw up in this round from Hellraisers, I think.
Definitely not as clean as it could have been. Doja will find JW though. This is still in the range of possibility for Doja. He's got two kills already, but Pronax and Olafmeister are sitting close range on him with CZs. So if Doja shows himself, it's very likely that he will be picked off immediately.
Yeah, if he had the bomb, this would be completely different. But the fact that he doesn't have the bomb means they can just play around that bomb and wait for him to make a move. Pronax might be able to spot him soon here. Doja is going to be walking out, and he has so many angles to check. So we'll see. After this round, I'm just going to try and go through what was really weird about what Hellraisers did this round. He's going to be walking up, 16 seconds left, and he does go down to Pronax. So nicely done from Fnatic. Great round. But here's the thing. This middle area of the map is actually very, very hard to control if you're the terrorist side, if you just walk in. And it's really obvious why that is. You can be spotted from the window, from catwalk over at B, and from the connector here towards the A-bomb site. So if you walk into this square here, you're going to be attacked from three sides. And the whole point is that you can easily smoke off actually all three entrances. Now, obviously, you don't want to do that because then you can't go anywhere. You want to try and smoke off two of them and then go the third way. And Hellraiser has decided not to smoke off anything and just walk into the middle. And that was maybe a little bit too confident.
I think they were just like, well, they're going to have pistols, right? And that's the overconfidence when you're thinking about ecofrags. But then the pistols now, they just deal so much damage. It's you always have to be worried at this point. Up close, if they manage to close the distance, get within range, the CZ, the P250, the 5.7, the Deagle, like those will wreak havoc on your team.
Yeah. I mean, if in Global Offensive, the pistols are so good that no team, and I think even every team knows that, Hellraisers too, that you can't just say, oh, it's just pistols, let's just go. But, I mean, yeah, they feel confident. They should feel confident. I mean, they're up 8-4, so they're doing something right, but don't want to let Fnatic back in the game. We sort of saw what happened last game when you do that.
Look at Pronax's position right now. He's currently waiting in the smoke, and he will get rewarded for it. Kucher, instant headshot there. Pronax was definitely waiting for the boost to happen, and now he gets the read as well. Finds Angel. Great play from Pronax. Those two kills just shutting Hellraisers down. Karims will find the last one on Doja. But Pronax with the control of mid really locked it down for Fnatic.
Nicely done. So 8-5 and the 14th round coming up, and Fnatic need to keep winning these last two rounds. They really cannot let any more go here. Hellraisers already have a very, very strong start to this first half of the game. Grenade up the middle is going to land right on Markolov, but actually doesn't do that much damage, and he only has a Deagle, so He's occupying three people right now. They gotta kill him quick or get out, because otherwise they're gonna lose the A bomb site. And in fact, they already have. They're just gonna get mowed down when they come back in here. Olofmeister taking a lot of damage. No, that's JW down to 10, and it is still gonna be a 4-on-3.
4-on-3, and there's the wraparound. Kucher pushing aggressively into CT, actually gets a kill off of that. That was a big play from him. Goes for the trick flash and gets another. This is at the end of Fnatic's hopes for this round. There is no way Olfmeister is rolling in here and pulling off a 1v4. That would be a sick play if he could actually do it. One for, like, the history books. But it's just too hard. There's no way that he could walk into this. It's not the triangle. It's been upgraded. It's the square of doom.
Yeah, this is, I mean, best scenario again here is just getting some entry, or some exit kills, sorry, and he will take down Markolov, who sort of is actually the man of this round, even though Markolov did not pick up a kill as the only guy. Well, Adrian actually didn't get one either, and Olofmeister dies as well, so no rifle saved. I mean, what do you think, Ven? I wish we could have been on Hellraiser's, you know, Mumble or Ventrilo or whatever it is, server, and listening, and we could understand Russian as well. That would be great, because I imagine as soon as Markolov jumped over the boxes here and saw three people, he just instantly made a call and said, oh, there must be no one in A.
He definitely called out that there was a ton of action in mid, but I think Hellraiser just would have gone through with that push regardless, because that is the same A push that they've done so many times, and it's been working most of the time as well. I think it, like, out of the blue, I would say it has like a 80% success rate or something. Something really crazy, so I think it would have gone through with it regardless.
And tragedy strikes up at the B hallways as Crims walks right in. I mean, we saw that on Inferno when it was Pronax, and he got a great triple kill off it. But Crims just sort of, you know, brushed up against the terrorist and wanted to get warm and comfortable, and they killed him for it. Now, Olofmeister and Pronax are left, and just Olofmeister. He goes down 10-5 for the first half in favor of Hellraisers as a pretty decisive victory for them here in the first half, at least.
Yeah, it really is. And given how good Hellraisers are on the CT side, I think this is going to be really tough for Fnatic. I think they need to get the pistol round if they want to have a shot at this.
Yes, I agree. There's no coming back, even for Fnatic, if there's no pistol round. I think that's pretty safe to say. Now, if you're just joining us, then welcome to the channel. This is Room on Fire, and you're watching the SLTV Star Series Season 10. Thank you so much for joining us, and hope you've been enjoying yourself so far this evening. If you have, then there are lots of easy ways to support us. One of them is subscribing, so you can chat with the other wonderful subscribers. You can just click the follow button as well. That helps us out. Or you can go and click some of these links that occur if you click, if you type exclamation mark follow. Amongst other things, our YouTube channel and our, you know, the Facebook of our sponsor here, Case King Gaming. If you'd go and click and follow that or like that link, then you'll be able to participate in the raffle that's going to be happening tomorrow, where we have our own tournament coming up tomorrow. It's three best of three games between Fnatic, Na'Vi, Titan, and LDLC, and it's going to be a great tournament. So you guys have to tune in for that. But now we have the second half coming up, and I hope you're ready for it.
This is it. Now we get to see what we have in store for us here in this pistol. And right now, it's actually looking very standard out of Hellraisers. 2-on-2. You couldn't actually beat this with a stick. It's going to be down to the fight mid again. Angel actually getting picked off early on short. That's not how this is supposed to go for Hellraisers.
No, that was a great grenade. Just landed right at his feet, and he'd already taken some damage. Doge's up here in the apartments waiting. JW going to peek in, and that's a quick headshot. Now, I mean, both bomb sites are pretty exposed. This is a 5-on-3, and Fnatic... And I like this from Fnatic, I gotta say this. They have the advantage, but they're still playing it slowly and calmly and just not throwing anything away here. That's what they want to do.
At this point, they can pretty much pick and choose where they want to go. And I think that's what they're doing. They're just biding their time to figure out what's going on and who's holding where.
Oh no, JW, he shoots once, Kucher's right here, he's going to pick down another one, and now the bomb actually can't make it there. And with 40 seconds left, now things are getting a little bit tricky. I hope that this isn't going to be them throwing it away, because they had a really big lead in this round.
Doesn't really seem like Hellraisers had an idea as to where the bomb was actually going to be coming from. Pronax manages to sneak his way out from CPL into CT spawn and catch Adrian rotating. That's another big kill that actually brings it back Fnatic's way. Man advantage now, but the bomb is on A site. Pronax stomping off towards B. Exactly, Hellraisers, they have no idea.
Well, it's a 2-on-2 retake. Kucha just checked the B-bomb site, so they definitely know nobody's there. And Markolov does have a kit still. So this round is not over yet. Krims with a good flashbang out, just keeping Markolov at bay. And Kucha's going to be coming in, and he has body armor. So we'll see how this unfolds. Krims is right there. Markolov misses the shot. Now it's on Kucha. 1-on-2. He's going to be charging in, and Krims ducking and covering. And Kucha out of bullets, trying to pick up another gun. But there's no time here. Just Olofmeister with a pistol. Grenade won't kill him, and Kucha goes down. Nicely done from Olofmeister, and nicely done from Fnatic. It looked a little bit scary, but they held on to it, and it's 10-6.
I think the fact that Krims is so far away actually ended up being in their advantage, because it took such a long time for him to get onto the A bomb site that Halvarys just started to think that it was a double fake, especially with Pronex doing the risky but very smart play and picking off aggressively towards CT spot and then running into kitchen. I think that kind of sold it for them.
So now the question is it time for the Fnatic comeback?
Can they do it again?
That's definitely a possibility. If they win the two upcoming anti-ecos, it's 10-8.
That's true. But at the same time, out of the halves on Inferno, I thought the Fnatic looked much better on the CT side.
Two different maps, though. Two very different maps.
Two different maps, true. But still, I don't know. T side, we have to see something big here from them, I think. Hellraisers, though, not going for a pistol armor buy at all, in fact.
Oh, Angel being boosted up there and could have actually pretty killed JW if he had been boosted a little bit earlier. And Flusher, maybe he has like a mission to use the MP7 because he certainly picked one up and that's always a little bit confusing. Not going to get a kill so far with it, and over at the B-bomb side, it's just Doja waiting. JW going to be pushing in, and Doja looking the wrong way at the wrong time, and that will get him killed. Adrian and Markolov left here 2-on-4.
Flusher, I don't know if the MP7 is the best weapon to use at that range. Right now, Krim's looking towards his connector. He's going to... What a shot on Adrian. Okay, then. And Markolov, now he's going to try his luck versus Krims, who's already putting shots through the box on A. Markolov with the deagle tries his luck, but he will not get anything out of it.
Markolov just backing up, and he's going to be backing right into Olofmeister any second here, so this is just going to be the end for Markolov. Yep, Fnatic 7-10, and they only lose one player in Pronax, so things are looking better.
It's definitely better. I mean, it's better for their money. That's the big thing, right? They... Losing one man on the offense like that is big, because now they actually get a little bit of breathing room if they can pick up the next round here with doing the same, right? But then Hellraisers are having none of that. All five members sporting CZ75s and a couple of HE nades as well.
Oh, Pronax right around the corner. Doja's going to be here, and he will not be able to take him down. I actually thought maybe Doja got spotted jumping down into underpass like that. It seemed like Fnatic were in the middle pretty quickly. But either way, it works out for Pronax, whether or not he got told or whether he was just quick on reacting. It's going to be just fine for him. Adrian waiting up here, and he's going to be alone, charging out through the smoke, and will take down Pronax. That's a heroic move right there.
And he gets two kills.
Yeah.
That's I don't know if I mean, that's just great play from Adrian. Getting those two kills pretty much saved the round for Hellraisers. They needed at least two there, I think.
It definitely helps them going into the first buy round. Still, you see players like Krims having 7k after buying, but that could cause problems for him because JW picked up an op, and that's a pretty big investment for Fnatic.
Ooh. Look at the middle here. That smoke from Krims actually fails, and that's a big problem, though. He just walks in the middle anyway and gets the kill, but you got to be really careful. Failing that smoke in the window, if the rest of your team is relying on it, can really come back to haunt you, but it doesn't seem to face Fnatic right now. They are just doing incredible work here. 5-on-3 early on.
Yeah, JW very patient over in the B apartments, actually manages to catch Doja peeking. So that was just excellent right there, on top of the kill on Kucha from Krims. And now Fnatic actually making the call to rotate over to B with the bomb. Hellraisers have already rotated an extra man over here to cover. That's Markolov now, who's waiting on the site proper. Shot from JW, does not miss. Markolov, however, or rather, does not land. Markolov does not miss.
Yeah, Angel goes down, and Adrian now going to be alone, and I'm a little bit... I don't know. I kind of see what they were going for here, Hellraisers, but I actually wish they would have just rotated everyone to either A or B, just because if you do that and you pick the wrong bomb site, you get to save three rifles, and it's not the end of the world. You can still, you know, have a decent round the next round, but if you do what they did here... It's just, you know, it's unlikely that one guy is going to, or two guys is going to be able to kill five people coming in. So Adrian trying to stay alive, 4 HP, and this is looking really good. Fnatic not just on the verge, they're very close to to equalizing the score, because if they win this round, and they will, it's going to be eco for Hellraisers, and we're back at 10-10.
I think Adrian is like the eco frag master, or like the exit frag master. I mean, that's what, like two rounds, three rounds where he gets two?
Yeah.
That's impressive play.
I mean, he's at 23 kills.
Yeah, but I mean, that's the thing. He's the one really putting in the work on Hellraiser's side right now. Markaloff, Doja, kind of lagging behind, surprisingly enough, especially after Doja's performance earlier on in the evening when he just seemed to be this unstoppable monster. So, I need to see Hellraisers wake up in a bit here, because Fnatic, they're on top of tying them. They're one round away from bringing this to a 10-10 scoreline.
Yeah, and I see, I glance over at the chat, out of the corner of my eyes, and Devorg is saying, it's coming.
It's coming, yeah.
Oh yeah, the comeback.
Devil, have they been practicing Mirage in particular recently? Because it looks like Fnatic, I mean, it looks like your team have definitely been putting in some work here.
Maybe they've just been practicing comebacks. The whole point is to just, you know, get behind early on, make them feel comfortable, and then just come back and destroy them. Markov here close with the Nova shotgun. Somehow is unable to click his mouse button and take down Olafmeister. Not that it would have made a difference, but still, you know, at this point, anything really helps out Hellraisers. They need to get something done here. Kucha going to try for the spray, and he does miss a little bit. Grenade to follow. It'll actually fail, and now he's alone and will go down to JW. A lot of damage done. I mean, look how low they all are on the top of the scoreboard here for Fnatic, but they all stay alive except for Olafmeister, and it's 10-10. The score is equalized, and Kucha has decided it is time for an AWP.
And I think go ahead.
Well, I think the most important thing for Hellraisers right now is not to lose Kuchers right off the bat, because that's what happened the previous two buy rounds for Hellraisers. And Angel, I think, is actually going to get down into underpass unnoticed.
Yeah, seems like he went there. Yeah, nobody's peeking him, so definitely a little bit quick. And if he walks up behind these two players that are up here, that's Pronex and JW, this could be devastating. Doja's covering the other side. Pronex sneaking on through Angel a little bit quicker, and he's going to have the perfect timing, but it's actually too late now.
The same order again. Kucher and then Doja.
He's going to have the bomb here. Crims, oh, please. Angel, turn around. Crims is going to be walking right in, and that's the bomb drop, but I don't think he can hold it. That's the problem.
Oh, there's a great position here. Adrian actually manages to pick off JW. Comes very close to losing, to dying himself. Now Angel, point blank, gets into a firefight, gets the kill on Flusha, but there's another one raiding right around the corner. Olafmeister chases him down, gets his hands on the bomb once again. And now it's just Adrian who's working his way all the way back through T-spawn. The bomb is going to get planted on B-site well before he can do anything about it.
Yeah, and I think the only option for Adrian at this point is to just save.
Yeah, but to be honest, I mean, this round should have probably been Hellraisers. The kind of pinch they had on the two people over at the B apartments was so good. They just had no idea, but that's one of the most interesting rounds I think we've seen in a while here coming out. Hellraisers.
I think the problem is that Kucher gets picked off in mid, because that forces a reaction. As soon as he goes down in mid, you see Fnatic moving forward in B apps.
And then Doja peeks to get information, and he gets clipped.
Down.
That's the thing. It was the same as the last full buy round for Hellraisers. Same order. Yeah. Kucher gets picked mid. Doja peeks in B apartments. JW picks him off. It's just, it's almost like a, how do you say, papier musique, a recipe right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it is. And they're not skipping any steps.
So now 10-11, and Fnatic take the lead for the first time in this game. They've actually managed to close out a 10-5 deficit and turned it into an 11-10 lead at the moment. So pretty crazy stuff. Let's see if they can keep going. Hellraisers, though, they've lost so many rounds on the road, they can actually just buy, and they did save one rifle as well on Adrian, who just will never die, apparently.
Doja just picked Adrian up an AWP.
Doja just got tired of the shenanigans with JW. He's like, I'm done with this. You want to snipe? Okay, we'll snipe.
Yeah, and that means they have three people over at the A bomb site, and great, flash comes out. Kucha picks up the opening kill on Pronax, and now they just need to keep this up. Fnatic do have a decent amount of money, but not infinitely. You know, it's not like they all have 10,000 or above, so they can be brought to eco eventually, and the AWP purchase from Doja definitely pays off here. JW goes down.
All right, now we have to see Olafmeister. Olafmeister puts a shot through, but Doja has already changed positions. And this is looking like Hellraisers are going to get on the board here. This is not looking like it's going to go Fnatic's way at all.
Fnatic are a bit of a no man's land right now. Unless they completely forget to hold connector, I think this should be an easy win for Hellraisers.
It should be, but Flusher coming up in the middle, opening up everything. Now up closes Adrian, and he's just a killing machine. He's going to take down one more, and looks like they actually might try and rotate back towards the B bomb site here, but they are making too much noise. And Angel, how does he not hear it? That was such an easy kill from Angel. All he had to do was look down. Olofmeister made so much noise that, I don't know, Hellraisers are making some weird mistakes.
Olofmeister
with another pickoff, and now it's down to a 1-on-2 here.
Unreal. The two last frags from him, and now it's down to Doja. What a performance from the Swedes so far. Flush and Olofmeister, they've made this possible. I called it early. And Doja misses the flick. Too patient. He's running out of time, though. He's on a clock. The bomb is about to go boom. He walks right past Doja's pulling a Doja. Once again, on Mirage, he's about to walk right into Olofmeister. One freebie. Now he needs the other.
Yeah, and there's no time here. Krims can just wait easily. And Doja's going to have to run away. And Krims does fail the kill on him. And Doja, well, I mean, yeah, exceptional play from Fnatic. But more than anything, this was Hellraisers just tossing the round away completely meaninglessly. There was no reason they had to lose that. Not even close.
Very curious to figure out what Angel was doing in apps there.
When Flusher got the first kill in the middle, right? The guy who was over at A ramp just plain didn't react to it. He just kept looking at ramp, just not worried about the guy walking up behind him. And his teammate could have easily told him, mate, there's a guy walking up behind you. But then Angel over at apps, I mean, the guy was running. Olofmeister was just walking in with 2 HP. That should have been just an easy frag. Even, you know, could have almost killed him just throwing a Molotov at him or something.
I could have, yeah, I mean, it was. But it was also, like, watching Olofmeister from his perspective there, that was a sick shot on Angel, but then an even dirtier shot on Adrian. So just, Olofmeister with an AWP. He is
It
obscene.
Is cool. It is cool, but that can only happen when they start doing, like, horrible mistakes. There's no way Angel could not have hurt him then. Now they're going to try for an A rush, and we'll see how this is going to unfold. Adrian down in shadows, not really able to see anyone. So many flashes coming out. Kucha completely blinded. This is working out great for Fnatic. The whole of Hellraisers completely blind now. Bomb does go down. Olofmeister doesn't die. That spray for the smoke doesn't connect. And in the middle here, Angel just trying to stay alive, but he's not going to do that for very long.
JW, if Fnatic lose that round, that is the really most ridiculous thing. That's on him. That's on JW. It's not going to happen. His teammates have mercy. They saved the round for him, but JW just killed Krims. That's got to be like
a blooper reel. That was a straight up execution.
That's a blooper reel.
It didn't even look accidental.
Did Krims say something about his mother or something? Like, what happened there?
That was brutal.
This is an incredible comeback once again for Fnatic. I mean, they're doing an exceptional job considering how far they've been behind, but Hellraisers are making some truly devastating mistakes that are just... Right now, it feels like it's at the edge of costing them the game, basically. And there's no reason why they're doing it.
Well, it's cost them 8 rounds up to this point, and it's silly things like... Aggressive. So what's Kucher doing at that point? He's running into mid all by himself, only checking one angle.
And he has,
with no backup.
And he has Doja in the window who could be checking for him. So it's not like, you know, it just absolutely doesn't make any sense anymore. I think this is Hellraisers just being, you know, shook, basically.
Shook up, no doubt. I mean, that's definitely possible. It is looking like it because it's getting to that point where now it might be in their minds where it's just like, we just can't get a kill. Because that spray from Doja to top mid on Krims should have been a kill. You would think that it would have been a kill, but Krims still lives through it and kills him instead. So, I mean, it's that moment where Hellraisers have got to be wondering, like, what the hell is going on? How is this even possible? How are we not able to get a single frag here? Right now, I mean, it's like they're so strapped for cash, Hellraisers. They're losing so much. I mean, they've lost like 9 rounds in a row, pretty much. But like they've lost, so they're at least able to pick up rifles, but they just can't get many nades to work with at all. No kits either.
Yeah, I think the story of the second half right now is that Fnatic won a lot of really cool rounds initially in the second half where it was just really good, but the few rounds, I think Hellraisers have had two basically, where they could have turned it around and got something on their side, they just threw it away from an overwhelming advantage. They just flushed it all right down the toilet, and that's painful to watch, but it's obviously great for Fnatic. Going to be the second comeback of this evening for them, and let's see if they can keep it up here. JW with the opening kill, Markolov waiting down towards Get Right, and he is going to go down as well, just easy sneaking in here. Fnatic making it work, and they're going to be at match and map point. There's no way Kucher and Doja can bring this back.
Nothing they can do. Nothing at all. I mean, right now, Kucher runs into JW mid. JW actually misses his shot, so a big kill there from Kucher. And if there's anybody you want to be picking up the AWP right now for Hellraisers, it's him. If he can just turn this around, and he is actually going to go back down, look towards bottom mid. Is he going to be able to get a kill from this, though? No, he will not.
Somehow, no. I don't know. I mean, it's kind of strange experiencing this, because Titan should have probably won against Fnatic on Inferno, and definitely Hellraiser should have won on this map, but they just haven't been able to. Fnatic, I mean, this new lineup has some potential. If they can mentally stay in the game, even being that far behind in the first half, 10-5 on the CT side is absolutely devastating for Mirage. That's not a lot of rounds, and if they can mentally stay in the game, that's a very good sign here for the new Swedish lineup.
It's unreal is what it is. They've taken 10 rounds in a row in their second half. That's just not supposed to happen. And now Hellraisers, they're going to fix this. They've seen it coming. I mean, they have to, Mason. The Angel finds Olafmeister, and now it's down to JW, who catches Doja through the wall. Nicely done there. Another one onto the site. Kucher is caught next.
Yeah. I guess right now, Hellraisers, all they have to do is not peek unnecessarily. That's all they have to do. If... I guess we could see Aiden or Markelov go to the top of mid and basically lock JW in, and they'll work from there. But as long as they don't do anything silly, this should be a round win for them.
Yeah, absolutely. But then again, the last couple of times when they've been in a...
Yeah, they have been doing dumb things.
They have been doing really dumb things, so you do get a little bit worried. JW making a lot of noise, which helps out, you see Adrian just basically following him through the wall because of the audio cues here. So that's, you know, how a good player actually can play the game. Just, it looks like Wallhack, that's how much you can use the sound if you're good at it.
Mm-hmm. The amount of information you can get as well. Two players, three players. But Hellraisers, they had to do it, right? They had to get one round. I mean, you don't let 10 rounds go by without getting at least one round. Not a team like Hellraisers. That's unheard of.
Even if they tie the game right now, Hellraisers, I would still basically hang my head really low. I would not be walking out proud of this match if I was Hellraisers right now. Olafmeister gets double teamed up in the apartments, and Hellraisers trying something a little bit different, at least some CT side aggression. The JW with a quick return, and Doja goes down. Now 4-4, and Kucher is looking to pick someone off, but Fnatic, I mean, to give Fnatic some real credit here, this is something they do really well. They pick someone off, and then they basically just, they rotate the whole team around again. So it becomes very tricky for Hellraisers, especially when they're this far behind and they're really eager to make a rotation and be at the right place at the right time. Fnatic is using this really well against them.
And look at Pronax right now. He's waiting right around the corner. Not going to walk through this smoke, though. There is a man watching it. That's Markelov. He's looking towards window, expecting the boost up. But Markelov is waiting to be able to cut off this A site. He is the only line of defense here, however, for Hellraisers. And Fnatic have made the perfect call. All four members are about to converge on the A site. And Markelov isn't even on it. He has to hold from here.
Oh, but Pronax waits a little bit too long. Angel was a little bit too aggressive, but you're right. I actually love the fact that Pronax did that anyway, because he gets a lot of information just sticking around. Now they're going to try and see if they can take this A bomb site, and Angel pushes through the smoke, and actually he's going to take down Flusher, who had the bomb. JW picks up one more, and this is not over yet. Still 25 seconds. Crims goes down, and then JW falls. But what do you think, Vendetta? I mean, that position that Pronax held there, it seemed to me like, even if he couldn't see that much, he could still hear a lot.
Yeah, it definitely could, and he could probably scope out quite a few of the rotating positions that Hellraisers were coming from. But again, I don't really think it would have been instrumental. I think the rotation time from Fnatic is too long at that point,
yeah.
And Pronax just remains idle for too long, really, for that to work out, but yeah.
By the time I thought I saw them get towards, like, get close to A-pit from T-spawn, I was expecting Fnatic to just speed up and just go for it, chuck the nades and run. But
yeah,
that just did not happen.
Yeah, because at a point there, Hellraisers had over-rotated like crazy for no good reason at all. They were three people stacked on the B bomb site with Markelov holding by jungle, and that was pretty much it. They had no A defense at all.
Look at this. Hellraisers might lose the round or the game right here. If Doja peeks forward, Flusher has a brilliant position, and Doja is looking, he's actually going to be peeking right here, but Flusher, I think, still has the advantage. If he comes around this corner, AK versus M4, Flusher right there does take him very low, and he does win it. That means now Kucher is alone at this bomb site, and Fnatic, they have somehow figured it out. Kucher's going to get one, and then he goes down, and the thing that started all of this was this really weird push that Hellraiser did in the middle, where they had one guy pushed up for no reason at all. It's not over yet, but it is very close.
It's close. I mean, Krims has to land a perfect shot here onto Markolov, basically. Or rather, not Markolov, but Adrian. Adrian, he's got to work his way around short. Krims with a very aggressive position. He's looking. Is Adrian going to fall for it? Is he going to check this angle? Adrian does not. He still gets the spray, though. It's down to Krims. Now it's just Pronax and Adrian alive.
And Pronax is too smart to lose this. Oh, no. Actually, I spoke too soon. Adrian will be able to take him down. I thought for sure all Pronax had to do was just basically wait for a second. I mean, we see how close it is. If Pronax had just hit for 1 second, that's why I said that I thought he was just going to be able to win that. If he had just crouched anywhere, he would have been fine. But I guess there was a fair amount of pressure on in that situation. 15-13, I still think Fnatic are going to be able to take this. This is so close, and Hellraisers are making some strange mistakes. That single guy pushed up in the middle with no backup from connector or window is just unforgivable.
You know what? I think we talked about this at the beginning of the game. These teams can't actually lose. This has to end in a tie.
Yeah, actually, you're the one who predicted there was going to be a tie, so...
That's what I said line. They were going
no,
no,
no, no. Sam was, yeah, Sam was the one who said somebody had to lose.
But
yeah,
this is like Highlander reversed, like there can only be two. I don't know. Like, there is no loss here.
And finally, for once, Hellraisers actually does a concerted effort to do something as a group. And they get the trade-off there. So, good on them.
Angel coming up for the underpass, going to take off Krims as well. And it's down to Olofmeister and Flusher here, 2-on-4. And you're right, they did something that tasted like teamwork. Who would have thought?
Would have thought that it actually might do you good.
And it tasted sweet.
Of teamwork.
I mean, hey, it's got to be a feel-good. That's like a feel-good feeling, right? You know, you're just like, okay. Things are working now. Hellraisers, I mean, Fnatic went 10 rounds in a row. Hellraisers, they're capable of going 5 rounds in a row right now, and it's looking like they've got a strong chance at it. Doja finds Olofmeister. Now it's down to Flusher with 4 HP, who gets caught by Doja. Double kill for Doja at the end. But this is it. 30th round. We couldn't have asked for a better match to cap the evening here. Hellraisers, can they actually make it happen, or will Fnatic finally close this game out after a 6-week?
Don't know. I mean, this is some crazy stuff. We just had one 16-14 game here on the channel, and that was Titan versus versus Fnatic. And now we're maybe going to get a second one, unless Hellraisers can force the draw. There is no overtime in this league, so we're going to have to see how it all turns out. Kucha in the middle with the AWP. I like that decision, because that means he can actually hold this, but he's got to be careful. Krims does take a quick peek in Kucha. Yeah, he should fall back because of the underpass here.
Underpass, but he's looking towards underpass right now. Goes for the flick shot. Not going to get it, though. Flusha manages to find Angel. It was a one-for-one trade so far. Now Kucher has to be careful that he doesn't get caught off guard, but the smokes are going to block him off. So, for now, it's a bit of a ceasefire, but the bomb is actually rushing through B apartments. It was pushing towards the site. There's still a man alive here.
Doja alone. He needs backup quick. Kucha does go down. They need a lot of people in this bomb site right here. The bomb is dropped, but I'm not sure that's enough. Krims is going to go down, and now it's on Pronex in a 1-on-3. He might still be able to do this, but no, they are way too quick. And Doja picks up a triple, and it's a tie. The
it
one
is
thing
a tie.
That couldn't happen, it happened.